Hi and welcome to my fourth video in the series about structure and bonding, and today we're going to go further into detail into ionic bonding. So last time I used the example of ionic bonding with sodium chloride. Today we're going to be looking at different combinations, first of all starting with magnesium oxide. So last time we were looking at the exchange of a single electron between different types of atom. Today we're going to be looking at examples where more than one is exchanged. And so an example of this is magnesium oxide. So magnesium, found in group 2, because it has 2 electrons in its outer shell, and oxygen in group 6, and that's got 6 electrons in its outer shell. Now, in order for those to become atoms, for magnesium, it needs to lose those 2 electrons, and for oxygen, it needs to gain them. And so what happens is they exchange the electrons, and they now end up with this situation where both of these are now ions. And magnesium, because it has an outer shell, because it has an empty outer shell and it's lost the 2 electrons, it now has a positive charge, because magnesium has got a proton number of 12 and it's lost 2 of the electrons, so it did have 12 electrons but now it has 10, and so hence positive 2. The oxygen, that had 6 electrons in its outer shell but it gained 2 more, and therefore because oxygen has a proton number of 8 and it now has 10 electrons, it has a 2 negative charge. And now what we have here is the simplified version of this, where we've just drawn the outer shell, so the magnesium, 2 in its outer, oxygen, 6 in its outer shell, and this showing the ions where the magnesium has lost the electrons and exchanged them and given them to the oxygen. And because the magnesium has a positive charge and the oxygen has a negative, they're attracted to one another, and hence you form magnesium oxide. So here's a bit more of a tricky example where we've got lithium and oxygen. So lithium, as we know, is in group 1, so 1 electron in its outer shell, and oxygen is in group 6, 6 in its outer shell. Now in this example, what happens is the lithium has 1 in its outer shell, so that donates, this lithium here will donate 1 of its electrons to the oxygen, and this lithium will donate this one to the oxygen as well. And now we're left with a situation where the lithium has a positive charge, because if you look at the proton number for lithium, it's got a number of 3, and now it's only got 2 electrons, hence the positive charge. But the oxygen, because it has 8 protons in its atom, but now it has 10 electrons, it now has a 2 negative charge. And because of the positive charges on the lithium and the negative charges on the oxygen, they're attracted and they form a compound, lithium oxide. And a bit later in the video we'll look at what the formula is for that. So this is another example of ionic bonding to do with lithium nitride. So lithium, again, group 1, single electron in its outer shell. Nitrogen's in group 5, it's a non-metal, and therefore it's in group 5, so it has 5 electrons in its outer shell. So what's going to happen is the nitrogen is going to take the 3 electrons from these 3 lithium. They then become ions, and you end up with these lithiums with positive charges and the nitrogen with a negative charge, a 3 negative charge overall, and those will be attracted. Now we're going to look quickly at chemical formula, and we're going to use the example first of all of sodium chloride. And so with sodium chloride, they need to gain and lose the same number of electrons, so in this case 1, and hence the formula for sodium chloride would be NaCl. With magnesium and oxygen, again, magnesium loses 2 electrons and oxygen gains 2. And hence, because that's the same amount, the formula for magnesium oxide would be MgO. But in some cases, this isn't always the same. So with sodium oxide, which is a combination between sodium and oxygen, the sodium needs to lose a single electron, whereas the oxygen will need to gain 2. And so therefore, in order for the oxygen to get enough electrons, it needs to have 2 sodiums donate its electron. And so you need 2 of them to balance the single oxygen. So 2 sodiums here to balance the single one here. And hence you end up with this formula, Na2O. That 2, it's very, very important that it's written in the bottom right. And that 2 indicates 2 sodiums. If there's no number written next to the formula, that indicates singular, so it indicates 1. So this means The formula for sodium oxide is Na2, so two sodiums, single oxygen. In this example, we have magnesium group 2, so it needs to lose two electrons, and chlorine group 7, so it needs to gain a singular electron, and therefore we need two chlorines to balance the one magnesium. And so the two electrons that are released by the magnesium, one of them goes to one chlorine, this one here, and the other goes to the other. And you end up with these ions, so a singular magnesium ion and two chlorine ions, and hence the formula will be MgCl2. Remember, the 2 refers to the chlorine. So in summary, ionic bonding occurs between metals and nonmetals, metals on the left hand side of the table and nonmetals on the right. Non-metal ions have a negative charge, metal ions have a positive charge, and they'll combine in specific ways dependent on their charge. An example of this might be magnesium chloride. Magnesium, its ion has a 2 positive charge, chlorine, single negative. Hence the formula they'll produce will be MgCl2.